The Third Level by Jack Finney. So children, yesterday we did it, the whole thing I told you in just one lecture. So today we will be just doing its reading. So have you ever had any curious experience which others find hard to believe? So did you have such experience in which you people have to you had to try to convince others? So did you have any incredible experience? Yes or no? Yeah, if somebody had some experience which others find it difficult to believe, are the ones which are supernatural, right? So those kinds of things the others don't believe in very easily. But here we are going to read something which is not supernatural, but something which is related to fiction, science fiction. It's a science fiction. Usually one can, one can know past, one can think about past, one can imagine being in past. But here is the person who claims that he went to past. Okay, his claim, is based upon certain evidences and facts. So what those facts are, what those evidences are, how did he really venture into the past? If yes, how? If no, how? Let's see this. The presidents of the New York Central and the New York, New Haven, and Hartford Railroads will swear on a stack of timetables that there are only two. So the presidents of all these railway departments, they will swear that there are only two levels. But I say there are three, because I've been on the third level of the Grand Central Station. So everybody says it is a fact, like there are two levels at the Grand Central Station. And the presidents, swear by the stack of timetables they have got. And there is no denying the fact like there are two levels in the Grand Central Station. Yet the narrator claims that there are three levels. And the reason for his claim is that he says that he visited the third level. Yes, I have taken the obvious step. I talked to a psychiatrist friend of mine. I talked to a psychiatrist friend of mine, among others. So he said, though I have taken the obvious step, it was very, very fair. It was very obvious that he went to the third level. That's why he even talked to many people about it, including the psychiatrist. So psychiatrist is also his friend. Along with many other friends, he talked about his experience of visiting third level to the psychiatrist also. I told him about the third level at Grand Central Station, and he said it was a waking dream wish fulfillment. So narrator, first of all, children, the first thing, why did the narrator discuss his visit to third level to a psychiatrist? That raises an issue. It's okay, he visited the third level. But why does he discuss this issue with the psychiatrist? What does it show? What does it indicate? What does it indicate? The way we behave, it's okay. Okay, some people behave abnormally and they don't even know this. Isn't it? Abnormal behavior, the people, those who do abnormally, those who behave abnormally, they generally don't even know that they are behaving abnormally. They don't even know this. It is the other people who take them to the psychiatrist. But here in this case, the narrator himself talked to the psychiatrist about this. So does that indicate anything? Yeah, you're right. It indicates that the narrator himself knows that somewhere he is very stressed and he might have sought a shelter in that third level. He might be aware of his mental disorder to some extent, right? So that's why he talked to the psychiatrist. So I told him about the third level at the Grand Central Station, and he said it was a waking dream wish fulfillment. So what is the opinion of the psychiatrist? The psychiatrist said that his visit to the third level at Grand Central Station is like his wish fulfillment, nothing else. What is wish fulfillment? Like when you wish or when you desire for something and your desire gets fulfilled sometimes in your dream. Okay? But in the dream you are sleeping, but it was a kind of dream when he was awake. Okay, so he says it was a waking dream wish fulfillment. So sometimes some people dream even when they are awake. But actually that is not being awake, that is being in a subconscious state. Okay, you people might have heard people walking in sleep. Sleep walking is a disorder. Do you know this? It's not a normal tendency. If somebody walks in sleep, it means that one has got some problem. That means that one's mind is not at peace. That's why one is physically also not at peace while sleeping. So sleeping disorders are, you know, dealt in by the psychiatrist. People go to the doctors. So similarly, here this person, you know, when he talks about his visit to the third level, which doesn't even exist, then the psychiatrist claims, points out that it might be his wish, dream, wish fulfillment during his waking times. He said, I was unhappy. That made my wife kind of mad. But he explained that he meant the modern world is full of insecurity, fear, war, worry, and all the rest of it. And that I just want to escape. So what did the doctor say? The doctor told the narrator that he had this kind of experience because he was unhappy. The moment the narrator's wife heard this, she went mad. If some wife comes to know that her husband is unhappy, what will the wife think? What will the wife think? She will, of course, think that her husband is unhappy because of her. Got it? So it's a humorous thing a little bit. So the doctor pointed out that because you are unhappy, that's why you had this kind of experience. Then wife was, you know, inconsolable. But then the narrator, you know, said, but he explained, then the narrator, doctor explained it, like what he meant by this. He didn't mean that the narrator was unhappy because of his wife, but because of the life. Modern life is full of insecurities, fear, war. Insecurities, what kind of insecurities are there? If you are in a job, you never know when you will be fired. If you are earning good, then you are insecure whether you'll be able to maintain that standards. Right? If one is poor, one is insecure about one's future. So war, you never know what will happen tomorrow. The kind of, you know, the world, what is happening now in Afghan or in what Taliban's are doing, that has made the whole world get tensed. Like who knows what one country would do against another, right? So these things add up to our insecurities. And insecurities take away peace from our mind. And when we are not at peace, when our mind and soul is not at peace, then it tries to find solace in the dream. Okay? Because mind needs peace. Our soul needs peace by hook or by crook. And when we are not able to find that peace in the physical or in the real world, then we get it in the dream. Okay? Then our subconscious self gets the peace from here and there by hook and by crook. So he says that because the world is full of insecurities, war and fear, that's why we always want to escape from this difficult world. So you also took an escape. You were unhappy in the world. So in your dream, while you were awake, you took an escape in that third level, where you thought it would be peaceful, where you thought it would be an ideal situation. Well, who doesn't? Who doesn't means that who is not unhappy in this life? If we say that somebody is unhappy, then the point is, who is not unhappy? Everybody is unhappy. Everybody is feeling the same insecurities, fear, war. So what is happening in the world is making everybody tensed. So narrator is of the opinion that why I only went to the third level? Why nobody else? Right? Psychological problems only a few people have. Okay, students, you know, they all have the same pressure of the exams, of the syllabus. But out of thousands, one or two children go into depression. Why does it happen with them? Because they are not able to cope up with the stress. Okay, the reason, whatever the reason might be. Okay, in reality, the reason might be that they were not regular, they were not disciplined. Okay, that's why they were not able to cope up with the stress. Or maybe what they were doing that was not as per their desire. That's why they went into the depression. So whatever the reasons, but it is a fact. Like everybody is unhappy. But unhappiness doesn't mean that we start having dreams while we are awake. Okay? Everybody I know wants to escape, but they don't wander down into any third level at Grand Central Station. So, but that's the reason, he said, and my friends all agreed. So psychiatrist kept on, you know, getting insisted upon the same thing. He insisted on same thing, that the narrator wanted to escape from this world. So he went to the third level. Got it? Did the narrator accept this idea? Narrator did not accept this idea, because he was of the opinion that if, like, that is not the reason for him to go to third level. Because narrator thinks that if he is not happy, then the fact is, like, no one is in the world is happy. Then why is nobody going to third level? Why he only went? Got it? So narrator doesn't agree with the psychiatrist's opinion that he went to third level because he was unhappy and wanted to seek refuge or escape from this world. Everything points to it, they claimed. Who are they here? The friends and psychiatrist. They all claimed that this is what the proof is. This is the only reason. My stamp collecting, for example, that is a temporary refuge from reality. So now they had one more evidence. Narrator was saying that I went to third level not because I was seeking refuge from the present. They said, no, you are trying to take refuge in the past. And the example is that you are very fond of collecting stamps. Stamps you collect of the past. So that is a proof that you want to go back to past. So your this hobby of collecting stamps is a proof that you want to take refuge in the past. Now narrator has one, you can say, argument to counter this. He will say that, okay, you are telling me that I am fond of collecting stamps. That's why I went to the third level. Because I am stressed up in this modern world. Narrator says that if my grandfather was also very fond of stamp collection. then can you say that my grandfather was also stressed up in that life? Because that time life was quite at peace. That time the things were quite better. Then people didn't used to be insecure or afraid of anything. Got it? So what I'm saying, what proof did the psychiatrist give that the narrator went to third level because he was unhappy? What proof did he give? His hobby of stamp collection. That is a proof. Now, what argument will the narrator give to counter this allegation? Yeah, he will give the example of his grandfather. He will say that even his grandfather was a stamp collector. Even he had the hobby of stamp collection. But at that time, the life was idyllic. The life was perfect. Then there was no stress. Then the things were cool. Then the people were at peace. Life was not mechanical that time, the way it is now. So, well, maybe, but my grandfather didn't need any refuge from reality. Things were pretty nice and peaceful in his day from all I hear. And he started my collection. He started my collection means that he was also fond of stamp collection. It's a nice collection too. Blocks of four of practically every US issue, first day covers and so on. President Roosevelt collected stamps too, you know. So he gives one more example. One example of grandfather and one more example of the President Roosevelt. That even he was fond of collecting stamps. Then can you say that he also wanted to take refuge in the past? Getting? So narrator is countering the arguments by giving example of his grandfather and President Roosevelt. Clear? Anyway, here is what happened at Grand Central. So now the narrator is going to tell us like what happened. Okay, so we are going to read about his experience at the Grand Central Station. Very important part of the lesson. The name of the chapter is the third level. And now we are going to read about what he did at the third level, what third level is, where it is, and how did he go there. So be attentive. So it's the page number 2. Anyway, here is what happened at Grand Central. One night last summer, I worked late at the office. I was in a hurry to get uptown to my apartment. So I decided to take the subway from Grand Central because it's faster than the bus. So what happened? It happened in the last summer. On that particular day, he might have been very busy at his office and he got late. So when he had to go home, then he was in a hurry to reach home at the earliest. So he was in a hurry. So he decided to take a subway from Grand Central. Otherwise, he might not have gone to the Central Station. He might not have gone to Grand Central Station for train. He might have picked up bus or something else to reach his apartment. But on that particular day when he was late, when he wanted to reach his apartment early, when he was in a hurry, he decided to take subway from the Grand Central Station. So here, do we get some clue that he might have escaped from that world? This is what the root of our problems is. When we are over busy with our life, when we say that I want to be best, I want to do the best in my life, but somewhere our soul is not at peace with that overwork. Because somewhere our soul wants peace, rest. Our subconscious mind wants rest. Overtly or... Gursimar, come here, beta. Come here. Have you got your phone with you? Come here. Show your notebook to me. Bring that notebook as it is. Yes. Okay. Now you don't need this. Okay, so where I was, how would you know? Yes. So this man, you know, he is telling us that on that particular day, he was in a hurry to reach his apartment. So what is the clue we are getting that his subconscious might be wanting to take rest? Because throughout the day, he was in the office. He might have been tired. Now he wanted to reach home at the earliest. So his desire to reach home at the earliest was a desire to be at peace. So that subconscious mind might have made him take refuge in the past. So the answer is there. Got it? If we are psychiatrists or the psychiatrist people, you know, they diagnose each and every word of the patient. From their words only, they get to know the problem of the patient. Okay, so here only the answer is coming. Like he got late at the office. From there, he wanted to reach home at the earliest. Going home means going for peace, going for relaxation, going for shelter, going away from tensions. Going home means this, right? So now I don't know why this should have happened to me. I am just an ordinary guy named Charlie, 31 years old, and I was wearing a tan gabardine suit and a straw hat with a fancy band. I passed a dozen men who looked just like me, and I wasn't trying to escape from anything. I just wanted to get home to Louisa, my wife. So narrator is telling his story, and from there we are getting the ideas of his sickness. We are getting to know that he was sick. What kind of sickness is being hinted at? Mental sickness. He says that at that time when he was going home, he is just a normal guy, a 31 year old person who was wearing the contemporary clothes, the clothes which everybody was wearing, the kinds of clothes. He says that he was wearing the same kinds of clothes which the others were wearing. He's only 31 year old. He just wanted to reach home. Like many others, those who were there, it was not only he who was going home. Many other people were also going home. And his only desire at that time was to reach home to be with his wife, Louisa. That's it. Reaching home to be with one's near and dear ones is what? That you are after peace of mind. Right? See, it's okay that we want to go home. It's okay. But when we are like, when we have just one idea, it means that we are a bit unbalanced. Right? So he says that I was wearing a tan gabardine suit. What does it mean? Wearing this suit means that it's not that he likes the old kinds of clothes. It's not that he's very old, only 31 year old person, young. It's not that he has nobody at home whom he loves. He loves his wife. She's there. He wants to be there with her. He is young. He has a family. And he loves the life the way it is going on. He's wearing the smart dress like the others. But the point is that why he only went to third level? Right? So why he only went to third level? Because he might have been obsessed with the idea of relaxation. Mind it. When you are obsessed with something, you become sick. When you're obsessed with your phone, you are sick. Just to get rid of this, you came here. You wanted to get rid of this? You came here. And here also you are not leaving it. It means that you have to counsel yourself. This is what the narrator Mental sickness can make you mad one day. Mind it. You should not be obsessed of anything. See, he is obsessed of reaching home. You can imagine. Everybody say, you will also say like, ma'am, we all want to be at home. Yes, but doesn't mean that you become mad to reach home. Okay, becoming obsessed of one thing can make you sick. This is what has happened with the narrator. Okay, till end you will, many people keep on wondering in the end, like how, why did he go to third level? Does the third level exist or not? So we are getting the conclusion in the very beginning. There is no third level actually. But yes, right now in the class, it is to get rid of online class. But in the offline class, when somebody is getting online, what is it? It is being obsessed. Get rid of your obsession at your level. Otherwise, you'll have to go to a psychiatrist. That is for sure. Okay. So then he says that I wasn't trying to escape from anything. I just wanted to get home to Louisa, my wife. So he said that I wasn't trying to escape from anything. But there is an indication. He just wanted to reach home. It means that he wanted to escape that rush, that traffic, that busy life. Isn't it? If you say, I just want to get rid of my phone. Suppose you say, I just want to get rid of this phone. It means that it is becoming difficult for you to get rid of this. Got it? I turned into Grand Central from Vanderbilt Avenue. See, I turned into Grand Central from Vanderbilt Avenue and went down the steps to the first level. So first of all, he crossed Vanderbilt Avenue. From there, he went to the, from there, he went down the steps to first level, where you take trains like the 20th century. First of all, if you want to reach a station, then you'd have to cross certain landmarks. So first landmark he crossed was Vanderbilt Avenue. From there, he reached Grand Central Station. From there, he took stairs, which took him to the first level. And it was the first level from where you get the trains like 20th century and all, right? Then I walked down another flight to the second level. From first level, I walked another flight of stairs and reached the second level. Right? Where the suburban trains leave from? Ducked into an arched doorway, heading for the subway and got lost. So from there, when he reached the second level, and it is here where the sub trains, you know, they leave. From there, he entered an arched doorway. He entered an arched doorway from here. When he entered this doorway, there he got lost. Got it? So I got into a tunnel. See this? That's easy to do. I have been in and out of Grand Central hundreds of times. But I am always bumping into new doorways and stairs and corridors. So here again, we are getting the clue to the fact like this narrator was not normal. He had certain mental disorders. He says that I am always bumping into new doorways and stairs and corridors. So if you go to the station, once, twice, thrice, four times, 10 times, 20 times, will you always come across new corridors? But he says that he would bump into new corridors, new doors each time. It means that each time he would escape into the new world in the Grand Central Station. Let's see. Once I got into a tunnel about a mile long and came out in the lobby of the Roosevelt Hotel. So once he entered a tunnel which went about a mile, and from there he came out of the lobby of the hotel. Is it possible? But with him it happened. So how he might have come out of the lobby of the hotel? What might have happened? Unconsciously, he might have walked from the main roads or whatever and might have reached the hotel. But subconsciously, he might have been walking through the tunnel. Okay, the people who walk in sleep, they don't know what they are doing. Okay? So, okay, we'll continue this tomorrow. Thank you.